Okay. In this chapter already we have learned about what is star, what is planet, and what is sun. Sun is just a star only, and it is the nearest star. Okay, it is the closest star. It is not very far from us, so we are getting it here heat and light. In sufficient amount, we are getting the heat and light. So the sun is having its family, okay, whom they are giving the heat and light and everything. The sun is having 8 planets in his family. And what is the planet? Planet is a heavenly body, but it is not fixed heavenly body. Planet is a heavenly body that moves around the sun, okay. Means all the 8 planets which are in the family of this sun revolves, okay, moves around the sun only. Just like you, your mother is giving you food, then you move around your mother only for the food and everything now. Similarly here, planets revolves around the sun, okay. So the solar system is the family of sun and its 8 planets. What is solar system? Solar system is the family of sun and its 8 planet. You can count here how many planets is there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if anyone will ask, what is solar system? You are learning about that our solar system. Why I am saying our solar system? Because our planet Earth is also the member of this solar system. That's why it is our only. Okay? So the what is the solar system? The solar system is the family of sun and its 8 planets, okay. Now children, why these planets are revolving, how it is revolving around the sun, do you know? Gravity pull, okay. Just now in the 4th chapter you have learned about the gravity pull of Earth's gravitational pull. All the heavenly bodies are having the gravitational pull, okay. So this all the body, not only heavenly body, and it depends upon the mass. So if mass will be too much, then the gravity pull will also great, okay. So sun pulls, the sun gravitational pull only make this Earth and Venus and everything to revolve around the sun, and they are fixed. Okay, their distance is fixed. They are not changing their distance. They are revolving around the sun in a fixed orbit only. It is not changing. Okay. These are the fixed part. This is only known as orbit. And this orbit is not changing. Mercury is revolving in its own orbit. Venus in own orbit. Earth in own orbit. Mars in its own orbit. Jupiter in its own orbit. Okay. So everyone is having their fixed path. In that path only they used to move around the sun. They are not changing its path. Children, earlier we were learning that nowadays we are saying that in the solar system there are 8 planets. But earlier we had learned that in the solar system there are 9 planets. Okay. And the 9th planet was Pluto. After Neptune there was one more planet we used to call Pluto, okay. But after some research and everything, it is considered that by the International Astronomical Union that Pluto is not a planet. We can say it is a dwarf planet, or maybe it is a planet of another solar system. There are many reasons behind this, okay, why we are not considering Pluto as a planet now. One of the reason is that we know that planets moves around the sun in a fixed path. But it was seen that Pluto, it is moving around the sun, it is changing its path. It is changing its path. It is not moving in the fixed path. So either it is not a planet, it is a dwarf planet, or maybe it is a planet of another solar system, not of this solar system, okay. So now we are not considering Pluto as the planet of this solar system, okay. In this solar system, how many members are there? Sun and its 8 planet. Okay, these are only member of the solar system. So what we have learned today, the sun is only star that is close enough to us to give us heat and light. Our sun has 8 planets of different sizes moving around it. This family of sun and its 8 planet along with this satellite form a solar system. Okay, the gravity or the pull of the sun keeps the planet in their places. The 8 planets that revolve around the sun are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Okay, and this is only order of this planet. So which is the closest planet here? You can see Mercury. Which is the farthest? Neptune. So okay, the planet are arranged in this order only. To learn this sequence, we can use a various way. Okay, one of the way we can say my very excellent mother. Okay, just serve us namkeen. This is one sentence we can learn. My very excellent mother just serves us namkeen. Your mother used to serve you namkeen, no? Your mother is very excellent, okay? My very excellent mother just serve us namkeen. In your book, it is written like that. My very excellent mother just sent us noodles. That also you can learn. My very excellent mother just sent us noodles. So from here, we can learn the sequence from M. My M I will take, that is Mercury. From very V I will take, that is Venus. Excellent E, that is Earth. Mother, M of mother, that is Mars. J of just, that is Jupiter. Okay. Then S of serves, that is Saturn. U of us, that is Uranus. And N of namkeen, that is Neptune. So now we can learn the sequence. Which planet will come third? Which is in third position? Earth is in third position. Which is in fourth? Mars is in fourth position. Now we can find out the position of the planet from the sun by remembering this sentence. Okay, my very excellent mother just serve us namkeen. M for Mercury, V for Venus, E for Earth, M for Mars, J for Jupiter, S for Saturn, U for Uranus and N for Neptune. Okay? So children, and in next class we will learn in detail about each planet. Okay? So just now you please try to remember the names of 8 planets. That is your homework. And learn its sequence also. Okay? Draw the solar system neatly in your copy. Thank you. Have a nice day.